Do you have any master locks to which you have forgotten the combo? If so, look no further than the Combination Reclamation Device, created by the Security Breach Team as a class project for the Embedded Systems Design Lab course at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. The hardware for the CRD340 is fairly simple. A solenoid pulls a shackle on the padlock, a stepper motor turns a dial on the lock, and a quadrature encoder accurately determines the position of the dial. All of this is driven by a custom-designed PCB. An Allegro A3979 integrated circuit drives the stepper, a pair of FETs drive the solenoid, and all of the I.O. to the processing system is electrically isolated. The processing system is a ZedBoard, a development board that hosts a Xilinx Zinc chip, which is a hybrid programmable logic and processor system on a chip. For this design, the programmable logic acts as a quadrature encoder and as a 7-stage stepper driver. The processing side is running a Linaro Linux distribution, which hosts a graphical user interface and the algorithm that opens the lock. The interface allows the user to enter what digits they know, then tries to open the lock, prioritizing the digits that the user entered. So, without any further ado, let's try opening the lock. First, the CRD340 finds all these so-called sticky spots, using them to decrease the number of possible combinations from 64,000 to 80. After that, it does a brute force run of these 80 combos to find which one opens the lock. Elaborate on the sticky spot algorithm in more detail. Master locks have 12 spots located throughout the rotation of the dial, in which the dial will get stuck if the shackle is being pulled. For our system to determine these spots, the solenoid pulls the shackle, then the stepper tries to spin the dial until it stalls out, at which point the encoder is read to determine the high side of the sticky spot. The dial is then spun backwards until it stalls, and the low side of the sticky spot is recorded. After both sides have been found, their average is taken to determine the actual value of the sticky spot, and the dial is spun past the high side of the sticky spot, at which point the process begins again. Of these 12 sticky spots, 7 fall in half digits, 4 share the same ones place, and the remaining one is the last digit of the combo. Taking the remainder of the last digit divided by 4 gives you the so-called magic number. The first digit will be the magic number plus some multiple of 4. The second digit will be the magic number minus 2 plus some multiple of 4. The second digit can also not be within 2 digits of the third digit. From there, all we have to do is try all the combinations of these numbers until we find the correct combo. Switching back to the lock in progress, it is almost finished. It takes around 2 seconds to enter a combo, a number which could be improved upon with various tweaks to the mechanical setup or by simply increasing the speed of the stepper driver. When the correct combination is entered, the pin sticking through the plunger in the solenoid will break the beam in the optical flag sensor, letting the algorithm know that the combination has been found. As this run finishes, you can see that the combination is 22, 4, 18. It only took about 2 minutes to run to completion.